I heard President Trump taking completely different points of view. Does he want DACA, but he also wants the wall? Can you help us here?
So he laid out four things at the very beginning of the meeting, and I think when he says he wants to do a DACA bill, that he is always including those four things into it. Dealing with how many people come with a DACA recipient in the extended family, that extended immigration, whether it is obviously the DACA citizens themselves becoming citizens. It's always about border security. It's not necessarily a wall. In fact, it was good to be able to clarify. It's not about a wall everywhere on the border. It's only where it's needed. Otherwise, it's technology, it's people, it's legal loopholes. And then the fourth area is an area called the visa lottery. It's a random drawing of 50,000 people worldwide that are able to become citizens. He wants to be able to clean that system up as well. But those four things that when he brings up DACA, he always means those four things together.
Now, it's interesting that you're saying that it doesn't mean necessarily the wall, because during the meeting, President Trump said the following, supporting the need for a wall. Let's listen to him.
It's wonderful. I'd love not to build the wall, but you need the wall. If you don't have the wall, you cannot have security. You just can't have it. It doesn't work. This should be a bipartisan bill. This should be a bill of love. Truly, it should be a bill of love, and we can do that. But it also has to be a bill where we're able to secure our border. And there being
so, Senator, here's President Trump saying that you need a wall. So what's going to happen?
So earlier in the meeting, he was highlighting there are only certain areas of the border that will need a wall. The whole border doesn't need that. Many areas are wide open. Many areas obviously have river or high mountains. They're not areas. But in high-trafficked areas where we're seeing a lot of drug trafficking, for instance, or different human trafficking coming back and forth, those are areas that he wants to be able to put up a wall, and then we're able to be able to enforce the boundaries of that wall. But we know where there are sections you don't need quite as many people to enforce, especially when there's a major city on both sides. His compassion statement, I think, was directed towards the DACA students. He's been very open to say that he wants to see them have the opportunity to be able to get citizenship. We should be compassionate towards those individuals, but we should also know that at our border, we have good, solid gates where people can come and go, but we also have walls in sections where we need them to be able to help enforce that boundary.